I would request Mr. E.S. Ranganathan, sir, to please give the special address.
Respected Sri Satpal Garg, sir. Mr. Jilledar, MD Green Gas. Mr. Rajagumar Pillai, President of ISGF. My colleague Sushil Kumar, and delegates for the Smart City Gas Distribution Session, speakers and vendors. A very warm good morning to you all. First of all, let me congratulate ISGF for conducting this session exclusively for city gas, because as he said, whenever you talk of utility, people, the first thing that comes to the mind is electricity. So to bring, and you know, in India, city gas distribution system was also not popular. Say, 5 years back, we had a handful of cities having city gas distribution. But now the government is going full blast. So under the leadership of the Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board, we have seen that already up to the eighth round of bidding, there are close to 100, more than 100 cities which has got city gas authorizations. And they are coming up with another big one. This is around 174 districts, 86 GAs. So let me say, by say in another 3 months, by end of June, half of India, because out of the 700 odd districts of the country, at least 300 and odd cities will have authorized city gas entities. So it's the right time also for ISGF to come up with the, you know, to give the importance that it deserves for the city gas distribution system. And I am proud to be the first member from city gas, as he has said. I was not knowing this. Now coming to the theme of today's this one, there was a small confusion in my mind whether it is, you know, it said smart city gas distribution. So I thought whether it is city gas distribution in smart cities or smart CGDs. So I choose the latter because, you know, CGDs are there and they have to become smarter and smarter to, you know, be in pace with the times. And as Mr. Pillai said, that gas has a disadvantage as regards to the electricity because the bill is small. So the, you know, the action to be taken are the same, the cost is the same, but, you know, the billing is small. So the cost of service as a percentage of the cost of the gas or electricity, so we will be more than the electricity one. So it is all the more important that, you know, nowadays manpower is getting harder to come by and costlier to get. So it's all the more important that we should move into a smart system. And when I say smart, I can see four areas where it can actually make a difference. The first one is what I find the growth of the cloud, because now people don't want to keep the data and the hardware and the maintenance personnel at their premises. Instead, they outsource it. And, you know, there was a phobia before that, you know, cloud, you know, the data is not safer. So I tell all the people who say is that when you have, you know, jewelry at home, jewelry in hand, where will you feel safer to keep it? Whether in your own house, in the Almira, or in a locker of the bank. So cloud is a locker in the bank, so the data is safer. And it is easy, expandable. You can expand the contract all at a, you know, very short span of time. Another one is the automated equipment. All the equipments need to be automated, remotely controlled, monitored, so that, you know, you don't need to go. Like, you know, today I was coming from Noida to here. It took me more than 1.5 hours. So if somebody has to come all the way from Noida to here to attend a or talk to an equipment, it will take that much time. And another one is to, you know, the produce the machineries that communicate, the smarter machineries itself, like meters and all. They need to talk to the server so that, you know, you don't need a meter reader to actually visit the place to take the meter. Then another area is the CNG stations. Again, CNG stations have all the equipment there also. You have equipment, meters and all. Of course, there are some gas supply systems which also need to be automated. And when he actually touched upon the subject of integration of all utilities, it was something which I had also in mind the day I joined IGL, because you know all the utilities share the same challenges, whether it is project, the municipalities charging more, taking more time to give permission, then the traffic police stopping us from actually doing the construction, to the operation, the pilferages, the maintenance challenges. So we have to get together, you know, like in UK, all the, you know, even the maintenance of electric appliances, gas appliances, all the appliances are done by British guys. So they supply gas also, but then they also maintain all the equipments and they maintain the not only the appliances, the network as well. So we need to have an integrated maintenance system and a billing. Billing is the easiest we can do. And in going forward, we expect that the customer also will be happy to receive one bill. Like he said, that he need not pay three bills and he need not keep track of it. He need not lose the connection because of non-payment of the bill. But here again, I would suggest one thing, because whether it is a smart city or a city which is having city gas distribution system already, the usage of gas has been very less. You know, when you think of gas, you only look at the burners. We only think that we should only use it in the kitchen. So when people started using in the geyser, it was considered to be a big thing. But then recently we had our team from IGL had gone to visit Tokyo Gas and Osaka Gas. There, you know, the revenue coming from the appliance, selling gas to the appliances, selling the appliances is more than three times what they, get from the burner. So we should have a single switch solution model, wherein a customer, once he takes the gas, he should be able to operate multiple equipments. All the equipments that he is using today, whether it is fridge, AC, heater, room heater, or water heater, all those things come with gas also. It's not a new thing. It's being implemented elsewhere. So we need to have, you know, the customers or the marketing effort so that the customer becomes aware of it and also the customer goes for it. I'm sure that once customer sees the convenience part of it, he will be grabbing it with both hands. Now, another thing which we saw is that, you know, the maintenance one is the patrolling and monitoring of the network. And when it comes to gas, that is a big challenge because we operate, you know, the GI pipe and the MDP pipes, which can be easily, you know, not tampered, but, you know, fiddled with, in the sense that when you are doing digging for something else, this can always be damaged. So for that, we need to have a what you call a, you know, system which combines man as well as technology, so that you use the, you know, latest technology and minimum manpower to monitor your network in the most, you know, profitable manner. Here we are also going for it. GAIL has implemented in in two of their pipelines, pipeline intrusion detection system for the cross-country pipeline. That's a very good thing. You know, you can even say that who is walking around, how many people, four people, one people, or somebody on the cycle, or somebody on the bike, within 10 meters of the pipeline that can be seen. But in city, that will not be exactly useful, but we in IGL has been trying to incorporate that. Shortly, we will have a solution put in. Our most thing is the integration of all CCTV cameras. We have six every stations and we have 426 stations. So think of the data that's coming. So video analytics will play a long, big part in understanding the alarm situations. We can also do the operation and maintenance also. Monitoring of the machines can be done. And mostly and most importantly, it will be the system-based database record of incidents and, you know, the corrective actions to be taken can be there. And these are the four major things which I thought that all the city gas companies should be looking at. And lastly, I wish all the delegates a fruitful day of deliberation and outcome for the betterment of the CGD sector so that it's made smarter and smarter.